Hello and welcome to another episode of the Open Journey. For those who didn't watch the Open Journey yet, it is a collection of open source games I found and I would like to present to you. And today I'm gonna show you Red Eclipse. Red Eclipse is a futuristic sci-fi arena shooter. And like the most of the arena shooters I already presented to you, also Red Eclipse offers the well-known arena modes like Deathmatch, Team Deathmatch, Capture the Flash and Flag and so on, but also new ones which don't any of the other shooters had are included. For example, Bomberball. In Bomberball, the goal is to get a ball into the enemy's base and to score the most points by this, and it is playable in 2, 3 or even 4 teams as far as I remember correctly. But each player can only hold the bomb a distinct amount of time. If the time limit is reached, the ball will explode and float around the arena, and the player who carries the ball needed to wait a few seconds until he can pick up the ball again. The rest of the game mode is most likely like team deathmatch. And yeah, the team with the most points winning the game. Easy. Further on, does Red Eclipse bring a new sort of agile movement to an arena shooter? It is possible to run and jump at walls to gain speed or to overcome a wall. But the most noticeable difference beside the very new movement type is the, I would call it, arena match editor. In which is based on picking your game mode and then selecting a huge amount of different mutators. Like Vampire, you will gain life points for any damage you cause to an enemy, or Resize, which lets you grow or shrink depending on your health, or Once Love, which will spawn waves of enemies fighting every player and team in the game to increase the difficulty of the game, and also there are a lot more mutators available, of course. Technical. Red Eclipse is based on the Cube 2 or Sauerbraten Engine 2 and does not really add new features to the engine itself, except of some minor cube script commands for a little bit more complex scripts, but nothing special at all. And also the good old Cube 2 level editor is present. The game is playable on any common OS like Linux, Windows, Mac and BSD. And currently the game is available in version 1.6.0 from the 21st December 2007. Backgrounds? I don't know any special backgrounds. It's just open source and somebody can grab the code and, well, develop a new game. So it is. Yeah, let's come to the final point, the ratings. I would give Red Eclipse only 3 stars. Yes, of course, this has a new, agile and funny gameplay. It is very recent, if we look on the last major update. It is in a complete development state, of course, and it has an active community, but also, for my feeling, there are too much life points at default settings. It's just taking hours to take down an enemy. Well, it feels like it took hours to taking down an enemy and you dying like instantly. I'm not really sure. The projectiles of every weapon is very slow. You can look them flew through the arena, and this also makes aiming a little bit hard for me, because every shooter I ever played in my life had bullets which hits the enemy nearly instantly, or which are flying very fast. But this relatively slow projectiles combined with the very fast movements of the players around the arena makes it very different to aim and even hit an enemy. And yeah, this makes the gameplay a little bit taxing. But it's not a bad game after all. If you're now interested in Red Eclipse, you can, as always, find any link in the description you need to get Red Eclipse or to get more information about it. And thanks for watching and see you in the next episode. Bye bye! First blood.